Well, now that financial times are tough, we're all adjusting, we're all cutting corners, we're sacrificing.
But tonight, KMBC 9's Maria Antonia is live in Eudora, Kansas, with a look at just how far some families are going to make ends meet. Maria?
Larry, I'm going to whisper here, and I want to show you why we're trying to be quiet. I want you to take a look at the two little angels we're hoping not to wake up, and I hope you can hear me. You should be looking at 2.5-year-old Michael and his 5-year-old sister, Lexi. Now, tonight, their dad could not tuck them in because dad is nearly 5,000 miles away, stationed in Germany.
Sergeant Jay Thorne spends lots of time in lots of places with a squad in Kuwait in a sandstorm south of Baghdad, but this poses an issue. The 28-year-old can be closer to one of Saddam's castles than his own home.
We made the decision, but I try not to think about it too much.
A difficult decision, since re-enlisting means he won't be there for more of the kids' birthdays or their photos.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard.
Jay. Here's welcome.
Pull them all out. But this decision was really our best interest in the kids, my family, my wife's family, my wife.
A wife who's expecting, they already have 2 children.
The Army does take care of you, and that's wonderful. The civilian world is a little more brutal. It's harsh.
We get free housing. Free insurance, we don't have to pay for electricity and water.
The couple couldn't find a civilian job that pays enough.
So you feel like you don't have much choice to go in a civilian world, and when you're not used to paying $800 for rent.
When you have a son with a medical condition that affects his hearing.
Since I've been on active duty, he's had 3 surgeries. We haven't paid for anything.
So they pay in other ways.
It's hard at night, you know, when daddy didn't tuck him in. All that good stuff.
We first met the Thornes in 2003 when an emotional Amy was surprised to see Jay come home for the birth of their daughter, Lexi. He's now stationed in Germany, had the family there, but brought them home so Amy could again give birth in the U.S. The sergeant who joined the reserves in 1999 tells us he knows at least 10 other soldiers re-enlisting for economic reasons.
As of right now, it's really our only option.
You know, there's webcam. Webcam's good. You just make the best of it.
Now, just this month, the Department of Defense released October recruitment figures, the latest ones, so let's take a look at those. And more than 5,300 enlistments were a bit higher than the Army's goal. That's also higher than the 4,500 who enlisted during the same time last year. Plus, all branches of the military report going above their October retention goals. So, is that because times are tough? Well, an Army spokesman tells me it is too early right now to tell that just yet, but also says that when times are tough, the numbers are good for them, although they don't like to boast about a situation like that. We're in Eudora. Back to you in the station.
Thank you very much, Maria Antonia. Sergeant Thorne has been emailing Maria from Germany today. Part of his task was taking care of other soldiers, including their transportation to assigned duties.